So to find the area under the normal curve of what we would call a left-tailed region, like I see shaded on the screen, I still have to keep in mind that if I'm going to use my calculator, I need a lower bound and an upper bound for the region. Well, technically, this region doesn't have a lower bound. If I had to describe it, I would call it out as negative infinity. But if I'm using my TI-84 to calculate the area, I access my distributions and I still choose normal CDF, which is number 2. And as the left bound, I can't key in negative infinity, but what I'll use is the calculator's lowest bound, which is negative 1 times 10 to the 99th power. So my negative 1 goes in, and if you look above the comma key, hit second and comma, you'll see a double E. Now on your screen, it only shows up a single E, but this is scientific notation, and then I key in the 99th power. So this is my calculator's lowest bound, and then I need my upper bound, which is a negative 1.26, comma, followed by the mean, which is 0 because this is a standard normal distribution, and then followed by the standard deviation of 1 because it's standard normal. And then I press enter and I have my area, 0.1038. If I'm going to use the Nspire to calculate the area, then I access menu and then choice number 6, which is statistics, and then choice number 5, which is distributions, and then number 2, which is normal CDF. Now by default, my lower bound is coming up as negative infinity. But if I had something else here to get that on my screen, I would just key in my negative, and then I would access my symbols, and so I would do control, and then the catalog here, and I have a whole host of symbols, and infinity is on that list. Okay, I'm just going to hit escape from here, and I'm just going to tab through. My upper bound would be the negative 1.26, and the mean is 0, standard deviation is 1, and I click OK, and there's that same 0.1038 as the area.